Hey, what up, everybody? J-Ton Gunter here, owner of Grapes and Sand Publishing and author of Fruit and Glass Wines, Cliff Notes, and Voice of Truth, a poetry book. Just want to let you guys know, this is my end of the year. I'm doing my five favorite wines. And so the following video will be all the wines that I enjoy. Well, five of the favorite ones that I enjoyed. I enjoyed a lot of them. This was very hard to do, to be honest with you, to pick five. But this is going from my platform from Wine Sale of the Week and also my Wine Wednesdays that I do weekly. So anyway, cheers, guys. Happy New Year to you. Welcome to another episode of Wine Wednesday, and of course this is a special one. I am J-Ton Gunter, owner of Grapes and Sand Publishing and author of Fruit and Glass, and also Wine's Cliff Notes. And today we have the 2012 Miley Champagne Grand Cru, and it's vintage, so 2012. I'm really excited to have this. I've heard of it, never had this one specifically. It is mostly Pinot Noir, it has heavier Pinot Noir there than the other ones, but it was when I was reading up on it, it's listed as a blend, so but mostly Pinot Noir when I looked into it a little bit further. We're here to drink some wine, so we're gonna drink some wine. So we have this right here, this little Miley, 2012. On the nose, I get lemon peel, I get a little bit of lime. There's also like a green apple going on here. On the palate, this is exactly what I needed. For my 100th episode, a little bit of champagne is exactly what I needed. This is very, very well done.
Let's get right into the nose one here. So immediately, off the nose, I get candy cherry. I get a little bit of raspberry going on here, and then also a little bit of blueberries. There's violets, so there's definitely some floral aspects going on here, like sweet violet. There's like a little bit of a tart, more like a kind of plum skinnish type of thing going on here. So there is some blue fruit and some red fruit here. There's also light spice, like a light cinnamon going on here too. Interesting. Let's go ahead and taste it. It's also a little bit of a minerality thing jumping out too. Let's go ahead and taste it. So everything translates to the palate. You definitely get that cherry, definitely get the raspberry, blueberry, and also like a little bit of that plum skin, little tartness, kind of around the mid palate to the finish. The thing that is really interesting about this though, there's two that are jumping out higher on the palate than they were on the nose. The cherry is definitely jumping out quite a bit, and also the raspberry. So it goes more into red fruit on the palate, in my opinion. Whatever. Let's get right into the wine. So I'm getting cranberry immediately out the glass. I'm also getting a little bit of like hot tar jumping out of the glass too. There's a spice element here too. I don't know what kind of spice it is. I actually have no idea what spice is, but something spice is jumping out, whether it's like cinnamon or cardamom, something like that. Something's jumping out of the glass, so spice wise. There's also a little bit of underripe cherry going on here, too. And like leather, like very, like if you have bought a brand new car and you went in that car, you'd smell the leather. It's like this kind of fresh leather smell going on. All right, let's go ahead and taste it. Okay, so let's talk about Barolo specifically. Nebbiolo out of Barolo specifically. One of the main things it's known for is its structure. Structure being the acid and the tannin. And it's considered naturally, Nebbiolo grown out of there, out of Barolo, naturally has high tannin and high acid, which is rare in a red grape. Like, you either have high tannin and like medium acid, or high acid, medium tannin, medium plus maybe, but to grow in Barolo, a lot of them come out the womb with high acid and high tannin, and this one is exactly as it's been perceived by me for years when it comes to Barolo. This definitely has high tannin and high acid. From what I know about brown, they tend to make wines, zins that can age for quite a bit of time because of the structure. Talking about acid and tannin. On the nose, so I get very, very small, like focused cranberry jumping out of the glass at me. Like cranberries for real jumping out of the glass at me. There's also like an earthy note, kind of a dusty soil going on here too. There's also like a sweet tobacco note here too, and also like a new leather smell, like a brand new. You just bought a brand new car, and you just finally get into the car, and it has that like kind of Napa, like new Napa leather smell. It's jumping out on the glass with me. Medium plus body. Medium plus acidity. Medium to medium plus acidity. Great grip. Great mid palate. So let's talk about the fruit first. The cranberry is definitely here. It starts in the cranberry. Actually, let's say it like this. The cherry is here up front. Gets paired with the cranberry in the mid palate and extends to the finish. There's also some of those earthy notes I was talking about. So the dustiness is there on the soil, like the dusty soil thing is coming in the third quarter too. Let's get right into the nose. So immediately I get black currant, I get plum. Some raw cocoa. There is mad layers here. So for layman's, for people who don't really drink wine to taste, they drink it just to drink, it's delicious.